है ना, सब लोग ट्रैक में ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं ना, लॉग आउट बंद कर रहा है।
ट्रैक में ज्वाइन करना भाई सभी लोगों ने।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। Yeah, good morning to all.
Good morning.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Sajjad sir, good morning. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, good morning. You are audible.
Yeah, good morning to all. First of all, I congrats Happy National Mathematics Day 2021 to all the mathematicians. I also congrats to Dr. Neena Gupta. Dr. Neena Gupta is the third woman to receive the Ramanujan Prize. She is the fourth Indian to win this prestigious prize. Now, today, we are glad to welcome Dr. Mohammad Sajjad sir, our special guest from University of Technology and Applied Science, Nijwa, Oman. Dr. Sajjad sir completed PhD from Jamia Millia Islamia University, New Delhi, India in 2003. Dr. Sajjad has published 60 research papers in reputed journals. Dr. Sajjad is the editorial board member for Journal on Mathematics, iManager publication. Dr. Sajjad has research interest in control system analysis, system dynamics, and computer simulation. Now, I request and again I welcome Dr. Sajjad for sharing his knowledge with us. Please, sir.
Thank you very much. It is my pleasure to share my work. Earlier, I was also part of this Calcutta. I was there from 2004.
I'm very happy to see you here, sir. Dr. Dushyant is there.
Nice to see you. Yes, I remember all those days with you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let me start now. Let me share my screen with all of you. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir, visible. Please.
Thank you. Dear participants, yes, today I would like to share my experience with all of you that is related to the mathematical tools like Mathematica, MATLAB, MapLS, etc. All that. So the title of my talk is today, Variation Among the Conclusions Using Different Mathematical Tools. As all of you know, nowadays we are mostly dependent on these mathematical tools. And we can say that these mathematical tools are basically becomes the beauty of our researches. We can easily, quickly find out this or check long-term behavior of any dynamical system, or interpretations will become easy with the help of these mathematical tools. Here, before 5-6 years ago, when I was verifying some results of an Iranian scientist related to my research. So this Iranian scientist has done all the work on MATLAB, and I was verifying all the same results using Mathematica. So when I have verified, so I, however, it was the same, I mean results are verified, but in different way. A lot of variations was there among his results and my results. So this raised a question that why this kind of variation we have. Then after some time, once again, I was verifying the results of another mathematician. He was a Nigerian mathematician, Anja. So I again found he has done all work in using MATLAB. And when I verified, so again, I found this, major difference between these two. So this raises the question, and I have decided to do this by myself. Then I found a major differences between these results or simulation when we do on MATLAB and when we do the same, having the same value of parameter, constants, initial conditions, all that. So when we do it on another, like Mathematica, so we find something different in this one. So today, this is basically the main issue I would like to show here. And before starting, I would like to tell you that I am not here to say to, I mean, this mathematical software is good, this is bad, all are very good, okay? And I'm not here to, I mean, for marketing for any particular mathematical software. And maybe today this all mathematicians who are listening to me may find my starting very simple, very easy for them. But I keep in mind a student side, okay? And I want to motivate them. And I know the majority of the students will not be, I mean, purely mathematician. They are from other specialization, engineering specialization. So keeping in mind, I have prepared my presentation today. So I will begin because actually I am from the field of synchronization. I am working on the synchronization, and synchronization is related to or associated to with this chaotic dynamics. So I will give you a brief, idea about what is a chaos. After that, I will show you my main, experience that I have, I want to share with all of you. So let us begin this with the linear system. Linear system, basically we can say a system that obey the principle of superposition. Okay, we can call that as a linear system. All of you know the principle of superposition. Okay, is defined as f of ax plus b for any function or for any dynamical system. Okay, so if we have this kind of property for any scalar values of a and b, so we can call such system as a linear system. On the other hand, we have a non-linear dynamical system. So opposite to this, the non-linear dynamical system, simply we can say that the system that do not obey or follow the principle of superposition, so we can call them, or such system we can call as a non-linear dynamical system. And the chaotic behavior or chaotic dynamics is basically the characteristics of all these non-linear dynamical systems. We cannot generate the chaos or chaotic dynamics from the linear dynamical system. It only will come from non-linear dynamical system. So let us know a little bit about this chaotic dynamics also, or chaos. Chaos basically first time was observed by a famous mathematician Lorentz, okay, when he was working for a dynamical system related to his, weather forecasting. So he observed the chaos in that one. So chaotic dynamics or chaotic behavior or chaos, we can see a kind of behavior of a non-linear dynamical system that has the following characteristics. The first, a state of utter confusion is there. We cannot say what is going to be happen. Okay. Chaotic system are highly sensitive to its initial condition. If you will make a very, very minute change in the initial condition, I will show you in the next slide with the help of example, that if you will make a little bit or minute changes in the initial condition, so there will be a change in the dynamics, we can say, of exponential order. And this long-term behavior also is unpredictable for such kind of chaotic systems. This chaotic system, we can term as, if you will make a minute change in the initial condition, so you will see a change in the dynamical system of nearly exponential order, a huge change you will see. So this we can term as, for example, if I clap here sitting in Oman, and the effect of clap, you can listen sitting in Greater Noida, okay, sitting in India, like this. So this kind of, okay, huge differences, okay, making a small or minute change in that initial condition, we can call as, or we can see only in chaotic dynamics, through chaos. Lorentz chaotic system, as I have told you, this famous mathematician Lorentz has observed first time this. So this is a Lorentz chaotic system. It is based on three variables, or it is a three-dimensional system. And it looks very simple, okay? But see what will happen. whenever we choose the initial condition, okay, for the given parameters in this one. So I have chosen here first x equal x, y, z, both are we have evolved with the one value. So we got this kind of strange attractor in the dynamics of this Lorentz system. This is a three-dimensional attractor or plot between x, y, and z together, okay, with respect to time. But if you will make a little minute change in the initial condition, keeping x and y both together at one, no change in this one. But if I will make a minute change in initial condition of z, so here we can predict this is going to be more complicated. You see here this one and this attractor more is going to be more complicated, okay? So this is basically, we can say, as chaotic behavior of a dynamical system. And this was first time observed by Lorentz. Here I will show you one more example, okay? We have three initial conditions for particular dynamics, okay? So at initial condition one, you can see the long-term behavior shown by this black color at x equal to one. If you will make further minute change in this one from 1 to 1.001, so you will see the up to, 150, almost the same. After that, it started to change, okay? And see how fastly or quickly it is changing. Okay, or entirely different behavior it is showing here, shown by this maroon color. And this, for if you will make further more minute change in this one, okay, so you can see around 100, the dynamics started to change and it is going entirely in different way. So this kind of behavior in which long-term prediction is not, unpredictable, and minute change in the initial condition will make a huge difference in the dynamics of the system. So such dynamics we can call as chaotic dynamics. Chaotic dynamics somewhere will be advantageous for all of us also, and somewhere it is harmful also. Let us see one example where it can be advantageous for us. You know, dynamics of this brain. The dynamics of the brain is completely chaotic, we can say. The functioning of the brain, like reasoning, memory, and attention, are completely chaotic, okay? And it need to be chaotic, okay? If you will try to control this one, then maybe the brain will not work, okay? So here, chaos is advantageous for all of us. On the other hand, the functioning of our heart, human heart, or any living being's heart, okay, is completely regular, non-chaotic, okay? So the functioning of the heart is, is completely regular, not the chaotic, okay? And you can see this dynamics of, healthy heart or, is like this. So it is a regular behavior, but if there will be some problem in the heart dynamics, okay? So it can go or it may become a little irregular, or it may show you chaotic behavior. So chaos or chaotic behavior is basically harmful for our heart. You can see here some irregularity in the heart dynamics, okay? I have here some dynamics here. See this first one, this is a regular graph of heart dynamics, but here we have some irregularity in this one. Also in this second one, we have two times irregularity here in this one, okay? In the third one, again, heart dynamics is irregular here, okay? So it is irregularity means maybe we are approaching towards chaotic dynamics. Okay, so here for our heart, the chaotic dynamics is not good. It is harmful. Okay, so heart wants to work regularly, okay, or in a regular behavior. But if it is going to be, irregular, so there may be a problem for the heart. So chaotic dynamics, somewhere advantages, somewhere harmful for all of us. Okay, actually my work is related to the synchronization, as I have told you before also. So here, let me give you a brief idea about this synchronization of chaotic system also, because synchronization we will do only for chaotic systems, okay? So synchronization is basically a process in which two or more chaotic systems, okay, we select and we adjust a given property of their motion to a common behavior due to either coupling or to forcing, by forcing them. We will, in this, actually we will do, we keep one system constant, we will keep one system as it is, and we will not make the changes in that one, and others, that system that we will keep as it is. It is called basically a master system or drive system, and other system we use to make changes in that one. We inject some controlling term in that one, and we will bring back to, I mean, match with the frequency with the master system. So other system basically called this slave system. So here basically we need two systems, okay, in synchronization, okay, in order to match their frequency. One we will keep as it is, we will not make any changes in the one that is called master system, and others is called slave system. To this to that we will bring okay close to the characteristics of the master system. So here I have this one picture. I will show you with the help of this what do actually I mean. So here I have chosen this one is variable from any particular system related to the synchronization. So this is a x1, okay, x1 variable from any system, and it is from basically master system, okay, shown by this red color. So we will keep this as it is, we will not make any changes in this one. And other system is called slave system, okay. So dynamics of the slave system is shown by here this blue color when we will inject the controller in that one. So if we add some controlling function in that one, so it will started to behave, or it will started to mesh the frequency with the master system. See, after some time around t is equal to 2, it is started to come close. However, this master system remains the same, but this slave system, as you inject the controller in that one, so it is started to mesh the frequency with that one, and it is started to behave in the same way as the master system was behaving. But on the other hand, I have one more graph also shown by green color. That is also for the same slave system, one of the variable from the slave system, and that is without controller. If you will not inject the controller in that one, so this was basically the natural or actual dynamics of that one. So it was about to behave like this, but as you inject the controller in that one, so it is started to come closer, and it will started to very soon or quickly in a same way, okay, or giving the same characteristics as the master system shown by this red one. So this is basically the idea about the synchronization. And during the synchronization of chaotic system, I have observed a huge variation among the dynamics when we simulate it on two different softwares. Because from long before, during the beginning of my, research, when I started my PhD in 2000, so I was working on Mathematica. And after that, in order to observe the differences, I also learned this MATLAB also. So I have done this synchronization both on Mathematica also and MATLAB also. So that is the reason why I have chosen Mathematica and MATLAB too. Okay. So here for the synchronization or to observe this variation among these two mathematical tools, I have chosen here the two chaotic system. This is the master system I have chosen here. This is basically Lorentz hyperchaotic system. This is four dimensional. Another one is Lorentz chaotic system. This is three dimensional system. And this I have chosen as a slave system. So these two system I have synchronized. So this master system is a Lorentz hyperchaotic system. So we will keep this as it is. And this we will make the changes in this one. We will inject the controller in this slave system, or this is also known as the response system. Okay. So here, actually I have considered the effect of some uncertainty and this noise also in this one. So this is the actual drive system, okay, that I have shown you before. And here, this is, I have added some uncertainty, okay, during the modeling of the system. Maybe we have something missed, okay, so that we have taken as in terms of periodic function. And another one is I have added some noise also in this one. After that, I have synchronized this one. So same order of uncertainty and noises I have also added in this response system, okay. This one you can see uncertainty, noise, and the last one, this is extra, you will find that is nothing but the controllers. So we have injected the controller in this. Now our aim is to find out the values of the controller. So in order to find the values of the controller, I have used here active control technique for this one. This is a very well-known active technique called active control technique. Applying that one, I have designed here three different switches. I mean, by changing the variables, I have synchronized first X1 versus X1. I will show you here, okay, in the end of this. And I have calculated the error. How to calculate the error? Error is basically given by the first error, because we have three dimensional system. So we will have three error among these three, okay, for these three equations. So first error I have chosen as here, the difference between Y1 and X1, okay. The Y1 is basically the treasure state variable from the slave system, and X1 is basically the state variable from the master system. So the difference of these two we have chosen as error. And in synchronization, what we do, applying the techniques, we try to make this error zero. As the error will become zero, so on the other hand, we can say, yes, systems are synchronized or they are behaving in the same way. So this is the error, okay? And we have calculated the error from the two given system, drive system and response system. After calculating this error, okay, this here, this is the basically controller U11 for the first equation, U12 for the second one, and U13 for the third one. Our aim is to find out the value of these controller using active control technique so that these errors will become zero. So applying the techniques, we have defined here the controllers, okay, in such a way that brings the dynamics, brings all the errors down or close to zero, this one. So this is all I have done using the active control techniques. So here, this is the controllers we have defined after substituting the value of the controllers in the slave system, okay? And we have checked the dynamics of the both the system on both the mathematical softwares, okay? For these particular values of the parameter, here I have chosen A is equal to 10, B is equal to 8/3, C is equal to 28, and this gain constant, K1, K2, K3, we have chosen as 0, 1, and W1, W2, W3. These are the gain constant we have chosen as 0, 1, 1. And initial condition for the master system, we have chosen 0 for all state variables, X1, X2, X3, X4, and Y1, Y2, Y3, state variable from the slave system are chosen as 1, 2, 3, okay, respectively. Then, this we have kept the same for Mathematica also, for MATLAB also. We have not make any changes in this one. Okay, and now I will show you some graphs here. So here I will show you two comparative graphs. The A will be for or simulated on MATLAB. B is on Mathematica. Okay, so where A is simulated on MATLAB and B is on Mathematica. Let us see the graphs here now. When I have calculated the errors, actually, error dynamical system we have converted into a linear dynamical system. So when we calculate the errors E1, E2, E3 on this MATLAB, okay, so at around 2, all three errors started to become zero here. Okay, you see, that was our aim. It means we achieved the stability and we are successful to synchronize the two systems that I have considered. Same. You can see here in this another graph also below this, that is a B, but actually this I have simulated on this Mathematica. So this A is on MATLAB, B is on Mathematica. So here you can find both the same, okay? No difference here, okay? The reason is because the error dynamical system was basically a linear dynamical system. That's why we are observing here the same, no variation, no difference in this one, same dynamics on both, okay? But when you see, this is basically the time series of the all the errors, okay, for the first switch I have considered here the three switch. I will show you the dynamics of all three switch here. Let us have now the dynamics of the state variable for the first switch, okay, X1 and Y1, okay. I will show you here all three, X1, Y1, Y1 with control shown by blue color, Y1 without control, okay, shown by this green color. And here red one, you really will observe here, but if you will see here, so you can see red one, because it is very quickly synchronize, okay, as around 0.1 or 2, the both started to synchronize and show the same dynamic here. Okay, so these two are overlapping each other. So this is on MATLAB. Okay, this is a dynamics of X1 and Y1 with control and without control. And see, this is a dynamics for the same values of parameter and for same values of initial condition. When I have same evaluated, simulated on this MATLAB, so I have found this dynamic. Now here you can see differences among this. However, in both, it is showing that system achieved the synchronization, both the state variable as you inject the controller in that one, okay, it started to synchronize very quickly, okay, in both. Here also you can see in Mathematica, okay, here in MATLAB, both you can observe, yes, synchronization is there. System achieved the synchronization, okay, and synchronization is stable here in this one, okay. And but if you will see around this 10, the dynamics of X1 and Y1 with control shown by this blue and red, this one, okay, and same below this 10, if you will see, so you can find the difference. So this is a difference I have observed. However, the values of all parameters, initial conditions, same in this one, but here we can observe the difference in this one, okay. See further here also, now this differences or variation is started among the dynamics of this synchronized, okay, this one. And here also you can see for uncontrolled also, see the green one, okay, for this this one, okay, and sorry. So here the difference is there. The green one is entirely different. In this region, it is nowhere. You will see the dynamics around 15, okay. So dynamics is different here. So this raises actually a big question here, that why we have this variation. And because if we are predicting some long-term behavior, so our conclusion may go in some other direction, okay, if we will observe the dynamics, or if we will predict a long-term behavior, okay, either on Mathematica or on Mabel, okay, especially for the chaotic system or non-linear dynamical system. See further, you can see, not only for this X1, Y1, we have a difference between X1 and X2 and Y2 also for other state vectors of master and slave system. If you will see here, again, you see the difference, okay, this, and it is continue. And you can see for uncontrolled green one also here, okay, this is also variation here, around 15 in the downward direction. It is nowhere, but here we have the dynamics. So this differences you can see in both synchronized or controlled dynamics also and uncontrolled dynamics also for the state vectors of master and slave system for first switch, okay, between X2 and Y2. See further on, here I have the dynamics of X3 and Y3, okay, this one. So here in this one also, however, the difference is here not too much, but it still is there. You can observe, okay. And more you can observe here for this green one, uncontrolled one, okay, for Y3. Here this is, and here if you will see in MATLAB above, so you will find something different there. Is that? So this variation is continuing, okay, for all three state variables because they have the nonlinear dynamics, okay. That's why we have the difference here. Or maybe due to chaotic behavior, we have the differences here, variations here among the dynamics of the state vector. So this is for the first switch. If we will continue, you see here the difference between the green one, okay, here and here. It is clear, very well clear here. Yes, so here this was for the first switch, okay. For the second switch, when I plotted the graph of this error dynamics for the second switch, okay, between E1, E2, and E3. So I have again found the same. The reason simple, because the error dynamics is represented through the linear dynamical system. Okay, so this is actually we do in active control technique, that we convert the linear dynamical systems, error dynamical systems, into a linear one. So that's why we have no variation here in this. It is the same. But when you observe the dynamics of these I mean state vectors of this master system and Celeuf system. Okay, when you simulate it on Mathematica and MATLAB, so here you will find again the differences here. See the dynamics of this controlled one or synchronized. Okay, here you see something different, and here you see two times peak around the 10, but here we have only one time peak in this. Okay, so the differences are here, you can observe easily. Okay, let us continue here. This is the dynamics of x2 versus y3. Actually we have changed the state vectors, and that gives us different kind of switches during the synchronization. This is called basically multi-switching synchronization. So in this one also, for another state vector between x2 and y3, when you see the dynamics here, so again you see here the variation. Okay, see here in the synchronized dynamics, this around 15 when we simulate it on MATLAB and we simulate it on Mathematica. So see here the variation started here up to here, I think 15 synchronized dynamics behaving in a same way, but around 15 or little before 15, it is started to vary. Okay, it is going now in a different way. However, synchronization both are showing, but dynamics in a different way here when you simulate on Mathematica and MATLAB one by one, keeping the same values of the parameter involved in the dynamical system and at the same initial condition. Okay, you can see here further the variation for another state variable x3 and y2 for the same second switch, this one. So here you can see this. Okay, up to I think little before 20, around 18-17. Okay, it is started to vary here, this one. And here this uncontrolled dynamics of shown by this green one, this, and here you can see this one. Okay, so variation is there among this. So this is basically I want to put in your notice here. Okay, this is during my research I have, this is for third switch here. Okay, so for third switch also we have in a same way, the dynamics is varying here, this one and this one different. Okay, so this is why we have this variation here when we have same values of parameter and same values of initial conditions. Okay, so this is continued here for all three switches. This is my research paper, is under review in some Scopus ID research journal, and soon I will get the reviewer's comment on this one. So this is I have shared with all of you, this one. And this is last, I have the graph of stability. I have shown stability of the synchronization through this Lyapunov function. So this is a graph of the Lyapunov function for three switches that I have considered or shared with all of you. So this we can say the system achieved the synchronization. Synchronization is stable if the Lyapunov derivative of Lyapunov function remains negative or less than zero, zero or less than zero. So here you can see all for all three switches, okay, on both Mathematica and MATLAB, this Lyapunov function is shows us it is synchronization is stable. So everything is okay, but the huge difference we have seen here in the dynamics of this both when we simulate it on Mathematica and MATLAB. These are the references I have used here. Okay, so this raises a big question, okay, and this can change the direction of our conclusions also. Okay, so we need to be careful. Actually, this kind of, because chaotic system are highly sensitive, okay, and if you will make a minute change that I have shown you initially also, you will find a big difference. So due to that one, or the reason, another reason may be the default condition that are we have in different mathematical softwares like MATLAB, Mathematica. So maybe the default condition are not the same on that. So if we will make the default condition same, so maybe we will get, I mean, the same results, okay? But due to the different default conditions in all these mathematical softwares, and also for this nonlinear dynamical systems, especially where we have the chaotic dynamics, okay? So that is why we have these variation among the dynamics. In spite of having the same parameters involved in the dynamical system, and the system evolving with the same initial condition. We have the variation, okay? So be careful about that. And this opens the door for all of you, especially researchers, okay? Also that you can apply, you can check all these in your specialization also and see what you feel, what you observe there, okay? So this is the experience I have shared with all of you. These are the references I have used. Thank you very much. You are welcome. If you have any question, you can.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your views on linear system as well as non-linear system. In this session, we learn about the brain system, etc. And I request to the audience, please, if you have any query, any question, then you can ask.
Good morning, sir. Sir, can you explain me which is better between Mathematica and MATLAB?
This is, I have told you in the beginning also that I am not here to say this. This is the experience that I have shared with all of you. Okay. It is, okay, it depends, sir, on you. Okay. Whatever, okay, is, you feel sometimes better, more better this Mathematica, maybe you feel better this MATLAB.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Any other? So, okay, sir. Again, thank you so much, sir, for this interesting session. Thank you so much, sir. Now, I request to you, sir, on the behalf of ICIAST 2020 Organizing Committee, please receive an e-memento.
Thank you.
So, this is forwarded to you. Sure. Moment. Sir, please accept.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Welcome.
Now we are glad to welcome Dr. Washim Khan, sir. Dr. Khan is Assistant Research Professor at Prince Mohammed bin Fahd University, Saudi Arabia, and held other previous position as Assistant Professor in Department of Mathematics, Integral University, Lucknow, India. Dr. Khan has more than 11 years of academic and research experience. Dr. Khan has completed PhD in Applied Mathematics from AMU, Aligarh Muslim University. And Dr. Khan has research interest in the area of integral transform and special functions. Dr. Khan is life member of SSFA and GAMS. Dr. Khan published more than 140 papers in reputed journals. And Dr. Khan has organized two international conferences in the field of algebra and analysis. So I request to Dr. Khan for sharing his knowledge with us. Please, sir.
Thank you so much, Dr. Dushyant Kumar. First of all, I want to, are you listening my voice?
Yes, sir. Audible, sir. Audible, please.
Okay. Thank you. First of all, I want to thank the convener of the conference, Professor Rajesh Tripathi, who have sent an email for the lecture. Today I'm going to present generalized Hermite based degenerate Bernoulli, Euler, and Gnocchi polynomials and Ramanujan's formulas. These are outlines of my talk, abstracts, introductions, Ramanujan's formula for J2N plus 1, and last is a new class of generalized degenerate Hermite Bernoulli polynomials. Actually, my talk based on Bernoulli, Euler, Ginocchi numbers and polynomial and connection between Hermite polynomials, like as degenerate special type polynomials. And now here in this talk, I have concluded connection between Ramanujan formulas. Today's National Mathematical Day for India, in India, 22nd December. So I will share with you a little bit of Ramanujan's formulas. Okay. Now abstract my talk, you can see we introduce a new classes of degenerate Bernoulli numbers and polynomials. Degenerate Hermite polynomials and generalized degenerate Hermite Bernoulli polynomials. Now here I have established some new identities related to the unifications of polynomials and generalization of three families of generalized apostle type Hermite Bernoulli, Euler and Ginocchi polynomials are given. Now I will starting from Ramanujan's first paper on Bernoulli. We will show how his celebrated formulas are generalized in terms of degenerate Bernoulli polynomials. Now these results extend some known summation identities of recently many mathematicians, Turkey, Koreans, Chinas, and also for India. Yeah.
Sir, sorry for interrupting. Sir, you have shared the PPTs or not?
Yeah, shared PPT.
No, sir, but it's not visible. Please share it again, if possible.
Okay, so wait. I have shared. Can you see my slide?
Sir,
no.
Sir, now it's visible. Now it's
visible. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now introductions of my talk, you can see for each integers k greater than 0 as kn, this is summation I 0 to n ik is called a sum of integers or simply power sum. It is that as kn is a polynomial in n of degree k plus n. Now the generative function for as kn is, you can see equation number 1.1. This is a power integers of powers. You can see second equation by using binomial expressions and the following known formula, this known Stirling number of second kinds. You can see equation number 1.2. Now here SRN denotes the Stirling number of the second kind defined by, you can see references 5. After that, one of mathematicians commented introduce advanced combinatorics, the art of finite and infinite series expansion. He have used the Stirling numbers in paper. So that you put the value here, k equal to 0, this Stirling number gives a value delta n comma 0. This number is called Kronecker symbols. Next, similarly, another definition of integers, you can see for integers k greater than 0 and n greater than 1, the alternating sum tkn is defined by, you can see equation number 1.3, tkn is equal to sum of I0 to n minus 1 minus 1 to the power I to the power k. Now this number, this alternating sum gives a generative function formula, you can see equation number 1.4. Now, some of definitions of Bernoulli numbers. You can see the classical Bernoulli numbers, Bernoulli polynomials, and generalization of Bernoulli polynomials. You can see equation number 1.5. These are generative functions of Bernoulli polynomial, Bernoulli numbers, generalized Bernoulli polynomials. Equation 1.5 to 1.7. Okay, you can see connection between Stirling numbers and Bernoulli polynomials, yeah, Bernoulli numbers. you can see there is a connection between Bernoulli numbers and power sum SKN. Already I have told you this is, you can easily find out the formula connection between Bernoulli numbers and Stirling numbers. This is, you can see SKN is equal to 1 upon K plus 1, I 0 to K, this K plus 1 VI n to the power K plus 1 minus I. After that, one of mathematicians, Italian, Diva and Rodrigues established the another, have established the another formula for connection between Bernoulli number and polynomial, you can see, which is a consequence of the following multiplication theorem. He have established consequence of following multiplication theorem, you can see. Now here, where n and a are positive integers. Now, next slides. Ramanujan was interested in discovering mathematical. It is very interesting part. You can listen and see. Ramanujan was interested in discovering mathematical properties of Bernoulli numbers. Bernoulli numbers were expressed as fraction example. Ramanujan said, you can write Bernoulli number in fractional form. Okay. So you can see, you can put the value of n is equal to 32. Gives a number this, you can see. Ramanujan you can define Bernoulli number. Well, Ramanujan found that denominator is always divisible by 6. He found alternate way to calculate Bernoulli number based on earlier Bernoulli numbers. The 6 of 18 number section of Ramanujan's first notebook of Wigan. Next, it will be observed that if n is even but not equal to 0. Now, first part is Vn, Bernoulli number is a fraction at the denominator of Bn upon n, in its lowest term is a prime number. The denominator of Bernoulli numbers contains each of the factors 2 and 3 once and only once. It is very important, you can interesting results, 2n and 2 to the power minus 1 Bn upon is a odd integer. Ramanujan has established the formula. On and on, Ramanujan paper went like that, filling 17 pages of the journal. Ramanujan wrote a first paper on Bernoulli numbers. Ramanujan paper had problems with it reached to the editor desk, and this was written by M.T. Narayana Iyengar, math professor at Central College, Bangalore, editor of the journal. Mr. Ramanujan's methods were so terse and novel, and his presentations so lacking in clearness and precision. It would later be observed that the ordinary mathematical reader, unaccustomed to such intellectual gymnastics, could hardly follow him. In other words, his paper was a mess. The manuscript went back and forth between him and its author 3 times. Now you can see Ramanujan's first full-length paper, research paper entitled On Some Properties of Bernoulli Numbers. This was published in the Journal of Indian Mathematical Society in 1911. In 1912 and 1913, Ramanujan communicated 4 short papers to Journal of Indian Mathematical Society. It is very interesting results. I hope you heard the number, Hardy Ramanujan number, 1729. You know, Ramanujan has hospitalized in 1919, and one of genius mathematician, Trinity College, G.H. Hardy, visit to hospital and say, Ramanujan said, today I came by taxi car. Now my taxi car number is 1729. Ramanujan replies the answer, it is very interesting number. It is the smallest number expressible as the sum of 2 cubes in 2 different ways. Hardy shocked.
It's very genius. 1729 we can be written as sum of two cubes in two different ways. 1 cube plus 12 cube equal to 9 cube plus 10 cube. Okay, now another definition of, after that, many met Euler, Ginocchi have established the formulas. You can see the classical Euler numbers, Euler polynomials, and Ginocchi numbers. You can see equation 1.8 and 1.9. Now, the following formula are well known. You can find they have established connection between Bernoulli numbers and Ginocchi numbers. You can see. And another definition of unification of Apostol Bernoulli Euler Ginocchi polynomials. One of mathematician, Turkey mathematician, Özden Özerslan have introduced the generative functions. You can see equation number 1.10. You change the parameter K, beta, AB. This equation 1.10 gives a known results of Bernoulli, Euler, and Ginocchi polynomials. Basically, name of unification of apostle type polynomials. Now, one of more interesting definitions, Q Bernoulli numbers. Using the notations, greatest integer Q equal to 1 of minus Q to the power X upon 1 minus Q for any X for Q belong to C with mod of Q less than 1. The Q Bernoulli numbers are defined at this, you can see. With the usual convention about replacing B of Q, now I is greater than equal to 0. Note that now applying the limit conditions, limit Q goes to 1, BKQ equal to BK, where BK is the kth ordinary Bernoulli numbers. Let FQT be the generative function of BIQ. Okay, you can see, write this equation. This is the unique solution of the Q difference equations. You can see. It is the easy to see that we can write Q difference equations, this equation you can see. Thus we have this difference which gives a formula in terms of Bernoulli numbers, BKQ equal to this DK upon DTK, this. Hence, we can define a Q analog of the zeta functions, Xi KOS as follows, this definition of zeta functions. Note that JQS has an analytic continuation in C with only one simple pole at x equal to 1 and JQ 1 minus k equal to minus BKQ upon k, where k is any positive integers. We can define a Q analog of the Hurwitz zeta functions, JQSX. This definitions, JQSX is equal to sum of n0 to infinity, q to the power n plus x upon n plus x to the power s, minus 1 minus q to the power a upon log q, 1 upon s minus 1. Now 0 less than x, less than equal to 1. Thus we have now put the value of x, and x gives a this equation. Values, Xi of 5 gives a value this, Xi of 5 of 1 upon 4 gives value this, this, and so on. Following connection between number theory and special functions. What is the connection between number theory and special function? All these above all these numbers. You can see theorem, this is irrational. You can read the paper. Professor Taekwon Kim and S.H. Kim, they are South Korean mathematicians. They have established more formulas based on Q Bernoulli numbers in terms of p-adding number fields. This paper published Advanced Studies in Contemporary Mathematics. Okay, you can see next, next topic is Ramanujan's formula for Xi 2 n plus 1. Ramanujan have used Bernoulli numbers. You can, a celebrated formula of Ramanujan, see references this, let alpha beta greater than zero with alpha beta equal to pi square and n be any non-zero integers. You can see Ramanujan established the formula in terms of two series. This one of formula is in terms of Jai and another formula in terms of summations. You can see equation number 2.1. Now here Jai S is already I told you equal to n is equal to summation n is equal to 1 to infinity n to the power minus s is Riemann zeta functions. And you can see the identity 2.1 implies another celebrated formula of Ramanujan. If alpha beta greater than 0 and n greater than 1 is an integer, you can see equation number 2.2. Further, if n is an odd positive integers, alpha, suppose that this is a special case of Ramanujan celebrated formula. So we will get equation number 2.3. What is revealed about the above formula of Ramanujan is that the identity given 2.1 complements Euler classical formula. We can be written as in terms of classical Euler formula for J2L. Namely that you can see equation number 2.4. While Euler formula shows that J2n is a rational multiple of this pi to the power 2n, Ramanujan's formula 2.1 shows that if alpha is a rational multiple of pi, then J2 of 2n plus 1 is a rational multiple of pi of 2n plus 1 plus an error term given by the sum of two rapidly convergent series. Now see the next slide. Ramanujan stated to equation number 2.1 in his notebooks, reference number 2.1, volume 1, page 259, number 15, volume 2nd, page same one, page number 177, number 21, and 2.3 in this reference 2.8. But he never published his proofs. Hardy, references 14, while giving two proofs of 2.1, remarks that probably Ramanujan used a version of Poisson's summation formula. And recently, one of Professor Bruce Bond from US, he have written a more books and like notebooks of Ramanujan's. Guesses Ramanujan probably used a method of partial fraction decompositions